Snow is great for skiing, making Calvin-style snow people, and also for drinking or boiling to make mac and cheese and sausages, right? Where'd you think that water came from? Hey everybody, thanks for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. The Sierra Nevada mountains in California are beautiful snow-capped peaks at any time of the year. During the October to May rainy season, the Sierras might see as much as 30 feet of snow, and they keep at least a little bit even during the summer. But a new study published in Nature Climate Change found the Sierras have almost no snowpack this year, less than the area has seen in more than 500 years, actually, which sounds kind of bad. Snowpack is what scientists call the total amount of snow and ice on the ground. According to the National Resources Defense Council, the NRDC, the state's snowpack used to store 15 million acre feet of water. Put another way, the historical average snowpack is about 28.3 inches. But a survey in April of 2015 found only 1.4 inches. And it's not just bad for skiers and snowboarders. Most of the precipitation that falls in California comes in the form of mountain snow, and that snow melts to then become our drinking water. Water from the Sierra snowpack helps generate electricity and provides one-third of all drinking water in California. In fact, 65% of all water comes from river and stream water. Because snow on mountains can build and build, it's a great measure of how much water will be added to the region as the snow melts. As it melts, the snowpack refreshes rivers, lakes, and reservoirs used for irrigation and public water supplies. So when the snowpack is low, rivers, lakes, and reservoirs are then not replenished, and the drought continues or worsens. The same process works around the country. If you turn on a faucet in Seattle, the Cedar and Tolt rivers come out of your faucet. In New York, the Delaware River Basin flows out of there, the Mississippi River streams out in Minnesota's Twin Cities, and Atlanta gets the Chattahoochee and Flint rivers. Here in California, we're getting snowmelt from those distant Sierra mountains. Surface moisture is what keeps us alive and cooking. It's the great circle of life. So the implications of a light snowpack are massive. We know this is the worst by comparing data, data, data. Scientists take cores of blue oak trees and compare the rings to determine which seasons were wet or dry. In wetter seasons, trees grow as much as they can, but when it's dry, growth slows drastically. Researchers compared snowpack measurements taken over the last few decades by satellites and by scientists in the field to ring data from 1,500 blue oak trees and found a perfect match. Using these two data sets, they found that this is the lightest snowpack in 5 centuries. 500 years. Why? Well, we are in a record 1-in-1,000-year drought, but that drought has been exacerbated by human-affected climate change. Don't just take my word for it, though. Bioclimatologist A. Park Williams from Columbia University told the New York Times, even though the chances of a drought like this were extremely unlikely in the past, in the future, it will be more likely to occur because of rising temperatures contributing in the 8-27% drop in soil moisture in California. No soil moisture, no tree growth, no snowpack, no water for people who live in Cali. And that is real hashtag Cali life, yo. 85% of United States residents get their water from public utilities, replenished or fed by the water cycle. I grew up with well water, which is super rare actually, but when people can't get water from dried up rivers and streams to add to reservoirs or irrigate their fields, they go underground to aquifers. Earth's surface has pockets of water in it that have trickled down over the eons, and we are sucking it out at a rate so fast that it cannot be replenished. And the pumping causes the surface to literally drop into the empty space. Some groundwater is being pumped down 50 to 100 feet below previous historical lows, according to the California Department of Water Resources. Water is a precious resource. Even if you live in the lush East Coast or in a country where water is easy to come by, conserving water is a good habit to get into for now in case a drought hits in the future. California built a whole farming industry in a desert, after all. You never know what the future is going to bring. Turn the water off when you're doing dishes, washing your face or your hands, and forego baths for short showers. These are good rules to follow, even in places that aren't currently affected by drought. Fresh water in the ground, lakes, and rivers only accounts for 1% of all the water on our planet, so don't waste it. How do you conserve water? You got any tips? Tell us in the comments. Speaking of comments, I always read down there how you guys love my cool nerdy t-shirts. I get them from all over the internet, and now I'm super psyched to announce that DNews is designing a line of our own science t-shirts. You can find them over on the completely new forhumanpeoples.com. The link is down in the description. Check out our favorites like this one. It's weird to wear my own face on myself. And also you can check out other fun stuff like phone cases, shirts, leggings, backpacks, and hoodies. Remember, click the link in the description, check it out. You can also use the offer code DNews for a discount. Thanks for watching, everybody. Let us know what you think down in the comments. We'll see you next time here on DNews.